First of all, I think they've gone, but I just wanted to thank Roisin and Anne for such an amazing inspirational presentation. It was beautiful to listen to them. So thanks to Age&Opportunity for inviting Carmel and myself to be here today. So as Adele said, my name is Rita Marcalo. I direct a company called Instant Dissidence based in Cork, Jordan in County Tipperary. Last year, Age&Opportunity in partnership with Dublin Dance Festival commissioned work that Carmel and I collaborated on called Spring as if trying not to on the earth. So what I'm going to do before Carmel gets back is to talk a little bit about the context for that work and then show a little bit of video. Carmel will then speak and we'll show a little bit of video, if that's okay. So the meta context for the work is my interest in the relationship between performance and climate activism. And so since 2018, when the United Nations published a report which stated at the time that we had about 12 years to make really deep changes to our systems of living, eating, traveling, to avoid catastrophic climate change, I made a kind of pledge to myself that through my work with Instant Distance, we were going to create 12 works in 12 years. In each year, we were going to take an aspect of this conversation around systemic change and the climate emergency and the way we live on Earth. So that's the plan. That was the plan. That's still the plan. So when I started engaging with Age&Opportunity on conversations on what this potential commission could be, I was very interested in looking at a particular aspect of this conversation, which is our relationship to food, the growing, transportation, and production of food. So this series was born. It's called As If Trying Not on the Earth. And it's divided into four seasons. So it takes its structure from the structure of nature, spring, summer, autumn, and winter. Last year we created spring and summer, and this year we're looking on autumn and winter. I intended to do all of them in one year, but it was very exhausting, so I took a year's break. So the collaboration with Carmel and the Commission for Age&Opportunity is spring, as if trying not on the earth. There was another co-creator involved, looking more at the food production, Julie and Joe from Riot Rye Bakery. So that was a separate work. And the work with Carmel was really looking at the growing of food. So before I go a little bit more into the work itself, just to say that initially when we started talking about this commission, it was going to be in person. So I was going to go and spend some time with Carmel in her gardens, learn directly from her. And in turn, her and I were going to collaborate physically on the performance together. But because of lockdown, of course, we had to invent a new model of collaboration. And that was challenging, but also really interesting. So both myself and Carmel went into this, and our commissioners went into this not really knowing how we're going to do it. And we sort of not just made a work, but we also invented a process, which in the end was really interesting to see it evolve. And now it's really interesting to reflect back and see what it was. So we ended up, Carmel and I, so I'll just talk a little bit about the process and then about the work. So Carmel and I, and this is where, Adele, do I have access to sharing from my screen, from my computer?
You should, but if you want to give it a go there, and if it's acting up, we'll look at it again.
Okay, so let me see. So our first question was, Carmel based in Dublin, me based in County Tipperary, how were we going to create this work together? And we knew that the final form of the work was going to be this concept of a performance to camera. So a performance which is not, which you don't create thinking about the physical space, but you actually create it thinking about it as something to be experienced on the screen and to the camera, live stream performance to camera. So how were we going to create this? So the way we did it was that Carmel and I, as you can see here, growing rehearsals, 1, 2, 3, we met every week for an hour and we had these conversations on Zoom. And these conversations were divided into two halves. So the first half would be usually Carmel will give me a lesson on what I needed to do in order to learn how to grow vegetables. I had never grown anything before in my life. And then the second half we changed and it was much more about me giving Carmel some tasks for her to create this performance for camera. So we did this for weeks. And in fact, if you're interested, I might after when Carmel is talking, I'll put the link of the YouTube channel on the chat, so just in case people are interested in listening to these videos. So each Zoom session we recorded and then we uploaded it onto a YouTube channel because we were also interested in, because we were kind of inventing a process, we were interested in people experiencing that process with us and noticing all the mistakes and mishaps. I'll stop sharing that now. So as I said, so this performance, the camera, that Carmel and I collaborated on, one of the things that we were interested in is to having this conversation between us be one where we are entering each other's territories and being a very non-hierarchical collaboration. So in the same way that Carmel was teaching me how to grow vegetables, which is her specialty, what she does, I was facilitating her creating a performance. And so we were kind of entering each other's territories. And so we wanted the final product to also reflect that. So the final product was actually a double performance where at the beginning, spectators saw a pre-edited film of myself throughout those months that I was working with Carmel, starting from beginning, cleaning the land, planting, etc. And then the second half was the live streamed performance that Carmel did from her own home. So what I'm going to show you now is a section of that first part. So what you will see is the result of some of what I learned from Carmel's teachings. And I will now share the screen again. Compost, weeding. Weeding. Bucket. Wicked. 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 Two. Brass, fair, far, fair. Manure, ouch, ouch, hola, okay, I'll pause it there. And just before I invite Carmel to speak, just to say that the use of badly pronounced Irish language there, because I arrived in Ireland just before lockdown. And prior to that, I spent 20 years in the UK, and I'm originally from Portugal. So my arrival in Ireland and then lockdown meant that I felt very isolated and really wanting to reach out to Irish culture, to Ireland as a country, and feeling like somebody who was failing to do that. And that failure was part in what I was doing with Carmel. It was things that I've never done. I've never grown anything. And I'm trying and probably going to fail. I am trying to learn Irish, but I have to do a Duolingo because I can't come to lessons because of lockdown, and I'm failing at it. But in that failure, there was always the curiosity and the attempt at getting to know this country that I now live in, which embraced me here. So that was part of this idea of trying something new, something which is foreign to me, and being explicitly a foreigner to it. Okay, so over to you, Carmel.
Hi. I'm going to begin with reading out an email that I sent to Rita while we were working together, because an awful lot of, like, on the YouTube video, that was where we would actually meet. But every week we had a lot of work that we did on our own batch. So Rita would send me off to do things, and I would send her films, and she would send her questions to me. So I just came across this, and even though we hadn't planned this, I'm going to read this out because I think somehow it sums up some of what we were trying to achieve together. Hi, Rita. I'm really going to think about the form of the gardening project in the next few days, because as you say, we're working within a new media. And we're not standing beside each other in the field alongside the farmer and the volunteers, with me saying, try this, do this, etc. This will be part of your experience, not mine, not ours. So it's interesting to see how we can work within these restrictions. I love your ideas, read the dance part of it. So the summary from where I am, working backwards, working from above, Babette and her feast, tables of lovely vegetables, buckets of beautiful materials to add to the existing soil, like leaf mold, small twigs, wood chip, manure, animal bedding, chicken manure, local green waste, locally made compost, heaps of cardboard for pathways and possibly underbed. Pattern language, the visuals, the colors, the smells, marking your space like an animal would, walking around it, over it, under it, feeling where you like to stand and sit, towing it with your feet, dragging your legs along it, looking to see if it comes with you or resists you. You can use sticks, but you can use chalk or flour, it might be nicer, or gravel to make shapes of beds and paths, throb pebbles as you go, feel the wind direction. Small is good, simple is good. We can go for plenty, or we can go for individual beauty in a plant. If you can grow one carrot, you can grow 100. Principles are the same. Mapping the site with your body, how many leaps, how many arm movements? How do you like to walk? Up and down, zigzag? How much do you like to squat? Writing and drawing in your gardening book. Who helps you? What day do you receive gifts? The extra courgette plants that someone has, for example. Where do you source your seeds? Would you like to grow some seeds on your windowsill? How to make space for other growers and other aesthetics? How important is the garden in itself? Or is it a vehicle for something else? Create a map. Know where and when you sow your seeds and your plants, where they come from, add dates, times of day, lunar calendars, weather, create story, or imprint an overall structure and plan from another and work within that. What is interesting in these times? Is this about joy? Is this a passion connection with others, moving, growing in other places? Okay, I just wanted to share a little bit of, there was a lot of richness in our conversations, and when I went out there on that toilet break, I was in the toilet and I was thinking, Rita has actually been in that toilet, even though she's never been in this house, because some of the, you know, it was like, that whole thing of that we met once this summer when Rita was doing her summer project, and I turned up where she was dancing on the street with strangers who would come up and dance with her, and I turned up to dance with her because it was the first chance I had actually had to be in a body experience. But yet, actually, I think we still feel more familiar with probably here in this space at this stage. And I suppose this morning, that question that you put in early about why am I here? And I was thinking a lot about why I'm here. And a lot of the excavations that we did during this project, and it was, because Rita was wanted to look at the no dig method, which is where you don't dig, but you just add and accumulate and layer in soil, that the thing about soil is that soil is made up of three components. It's the living, but it's the recently dead, and it's the very dead. And in our excavations, it was a lot about death was what came up. And even today is the 10-year anniversary of one of my oldest friends. And I think if it actually wasn't for Angela Stenson, I probably wouldn't be here today, because somehow it was her shock death that made me think, okay, if I actually want to do some creative work and theatre work and performance work, I better get going. And I was at a funeral just at the weekend, again back to death, and the priest was talking about embodying whoever has died, like taking one or two of their characteristics. And there's something about that, like as in soil, as in people, as in where we are, that if we're a layer of all the experiences, of all the gestures, of all the people who have passed through us that we have known, living and dead. And this project was just amazing, that instead of it showcasing kind of the lovely lush gardens that I'm lucky to live right beside, it became something that was much more about our inner layers. And it was a pleasure to work with Rita. And I'm also really happy to be here, and thank you for the opportunity to be here as well. And Rita's going to show a little bit of the clip from that bathroom kitchen. Okay.
Yes, thank you. Okay, yes, so I'm just going to show a little bit of, so you've seen the result of what I did from Carmel's teachings, and then you're going to see the amazing Carmel Ennis performing her work. So I am ready to share now. So just a small 2 minutes excerpt. And there is no sound, so it's supposed to be in silence. Okay, so that's just a little section of the work, and we'll stop there because I think we're over time. Apologies. Thank you very much for listening and watching.